nephew out. The clerk let two other people in. They were portly gentlemen, pleasant to behold, and they now stood in Scrooge's office with their hats off, books and papers in their hands, bowing to him.
"Scrooge and Marley, I believe,"
said one of the gentlemen, referring to his list.
"Do I have the pleasure of addressing Mr. Scrooge or Mr. Marley?"
"Well, you haven't the pleasure of addressing Mr. Marley. Mr. Marley has been dead these 7 years. He died 7 years ago, this very night. We are quite certain that his liberality will be well represented by his surviving partner."
"Liberality?"
"At this festive season of the year, Mr. Scrooge, it is more than usually desirable for us to make some slight provisions for the poor and destitute who suffer greatly at the present time. Many thousands are without common necessaries. Hundreds of thousands without common comforts."
"Are there no prisons?"
"Plenty of prisons, sir," said the gentleman.
"And the union workhouses, are they still in operation?"
"They are, though I wish I could say they were not.
The treadmill and the poor law are in full vigour, then?"
"They are both quite busy, sir."
"Oh, I was afraid from what you said at first that something had occurred to stop them in their useful course. I'm so glad to hear it."
But under the impression that they scarcely provide Christian cheer of mind and body for the unoffending multitudes a few of us are endeavoring to raise a fund to buy the poor some meat and drink and means of warmth, we choose this time of year because it is a time of all others when want is keenly felt and abundance rejoices. What shall we put you down for?"
"Nothing." "Oh, you... you wish to be anonymous?"
"I wish to be left alone. You ask me what I wish, gentlemen. That is my answer. I do not make merry myself at Christmas. I cannot afford to make idle people merry. I help to pay for the workhouses and the prisons. They cost enough. Those who are badly off must go there.
Many of them can't go there, Mr. Scrooge. Many would rather die."
"Well, if they would rather die, they'd better do it and decrease the surplus population. Besides, I don't know that."
"But you might know it."
"It's not my business to know it. It's enough for a man to understand his own business without interfering in other people's. Mine occupies me constantly. Good afternoon, gentlemen." Seeing that it would be pointless for them to pursue their point, the gentlemen withdrew, and Scrooge resumed his labors with an improved opinion of himself. And the folk